thanks for sitting down with us. It's the first time we've been able to talk to you since viewing this new documentary that's out on Hulu. Talk about, I know it's always difficult for you to talk about these things. Why do this documentary?
When we approached this idea of the documentary 3.5 years ago, my goal was to use it as one more resource to find Morgan, to try one more thing. You know, that's my job as her mom, is to make sure we don't leave any stone unturned. And this felt like a very good way to be able to do that, to tell her story nationally, since we don't know where she is.
You watched the documentary?
We did watch the documentary. My family watched the documentary. And even though, you know, it ends hard with evidence that we didn't want and didn't expect, the bottom line is that we still don't have Morgan back. We still don't know where she is, and so she is still missing, and our fight is still to bring her home. And even if we can't bring her home the way we planned, which grieves my soul, she still deserves to come home.
You talked about probabilities versus possibilities.
The probability is very strong that Morgan will not come home to be part of our family. But the possibility exists because no one has ever proved that she won't come home. And so I choose not to fight for the probability, but to fight for the possibility. You know, Morgan is a daughter and a sister and a granddaughter, and she deserves to be fought for. At this point, we can either quit or push forward, and both of those things are hard, but I choose my hard, and that is to continue to fight for my daughter.
Love always hopes?
Love always hopes. Comes right out of the Bible, and it talks about love always hopes. Doesn't give up, doesn't get tired, doesn't go away, but fights every day.
No matter how difficult.
This is my child. Of course I'm going to fight for her no matter how hard it gets. Any parent would do the same thing. And it may not make sense to other people that we're still out here 28 years later fighting for Morgan, but she is worth fighting for.
You know, one thing I did not see in the documentary, that age progressed picture. In my stories, should I use that?
No.
No? Tell me.
Well, we're fighting for who we know Morgan to be, who she was that night when she was missing, who people would have seen that night. You know, in the documentary, we talked about how there are other children that may have been victims of this man. But there are children, there are almost 2,000 children reported missing every day in the United States. That's an epidemic. If we had 2,000 of anybody else who was missing, we would not tolerate that. And so, our job as adults in the community is when we see a child who looks like they're in trouble, our job is to make that call. We don't have to be able to say that they're kidnapped or to know that information, but if we see a child in trouble, we should make that call. And that's what I hope people do when they see this documentary. The next time they look around and see a child in trouble, that they call the police and they let them make that decision for that child.
Watching that, I was reminded, and through the investigations, the names, the potential persons of interest, suspects that were known to police and stuff. I know at times that's had to be frustrating because I'm saying, what's the deal, for lack of a better way to say it? And I know you're saying that too, but having been involved so closely with the investigation, I know you see both sides of that, do you not?
So we've had a really incredible working relationship with the law enforcement involved in Morgan's case, and because they kept us involved and they continued to communicate with us, and we had a very good idea of what was going on, it probably wasn't as frustrating for us as it is for other people who are just now finding out information. But I have a lot of faith and trust in our law enforcement team to do the right things. You know, we didn't have all the resources back in 1995. They just didn't exist. And our team, Chief Russell White, he did everything he knew to do. And he brought in outside resources. He brought in the U.S. Marshals and the FBI and the National Center for Missing Children. He had 10 agencies on site the night that Morgan was taken. You know, they gave it everything they had. And as years have gone on and we've gained new technology, we have utilized all of that.
And to know that it's not a case that's simply sitting in a file cabinet somewhere, so to speak. There are agents, investigators actively working it right now.
Yeah, Morgan's case will never sit in a file untouched. I won't let that happen.
What do you want people to know? I ask you that every time. What do you want people to know? There's a new documentary, four parts.
You know, I hope people will watch it and really take to heart that in this documentary, there are two children whose lives were absolutely stolen from them. And that we as communities can make a difference so that it doesn't happen. And so that if it should happen again, that we're prepared to full out rescue that child immediately and they don't become a statistic.
And lastly, I have to, we alluded to it, that last piece of evidence you say that you did not want to hear or see, but you previously said you're not pinning all your ideas and beliefs on one key thing as well.
Well, you know, the evidence that we have is not something I want to see, for sure, but I still don't have Morgan. We have the evidence, we have a truck, we have a guy who committed terrible crimes against children, and fibers from her shirt were found in that truck, but we don't have her. And so the FBI and the Alma police and the state police, their job is to continue to work those leads, and my job is to continue to fight to find Morgan.
Which is something you'll do every day until you get answers.
Absolutely. I met Patty Wetterling shortly after Morgan was taken. I saw her name in a magazine. I called her foundation. She called me back the next day. Out of that, Patty and I became really close friends, and we started teaching law enforcement classes, doing training classes for law enforcement. In the response to missing children. And we have taught for 25 years together all across the nation. And the bonus to that is multiple times a month, I get to lay out Morgan's case in front of law enforcement from all across the country. And they always have feedback. They always say, did you try this? Did you guys think of that? And I would always come home to our law enforcement team and said, did we try this? Did we think of this? And Chief Russell White would say, oh, you've been instructing a class again. I said, yes. But I brought those ideas home because we have to try everything. Mm. And Patty.
She's a dear friend.
She's a heart friend.
Mm. You still talk every
week? Oh, yes. And we've talked multiple times as the documentary was coming out and over the weekend and how it affected their family and how it affected my family. You know, Patty and I started Team Hope, which is an organization at the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, because out of our need to connect to other parents and to not have families be isolated when a child is missing, we created Team Hope. That is now, it works all across the United States, providing support to every single family with a missing child. It doesn't matter how that child is missing, whether they're considered a runaway or an abduction or a parental abduction, we provide support with our team at the National Center to all those families. That's something I'm really proud of, Jacob and Morgan's legacy.
And we should mention the Morgan Nick Foundation. We haven't mentioned that. Let's do it while we're going.
Okay.
I didn't realize, Patty, she has a similar foundation.
Yes, so they had it for years and years, and it still exists, but it's part of another organization now, so they just do a lot of education is what they do. But yeah, we have the Morgan Nick Foundation. We serve families here in Arkansas. We serve missing children and missing adults. Last year we had 1,892 cases of missing Arkansans come through our office. Somebody has to fight for all them. Somebody has to stand with the family as they work with law enforcement to figure out what is happening, to facilitate counseling and resources when that person is returned. And, you know, we have an incredible staff who fights every day for missing persons.
And you have real results.
Oh, we have great results. We have a welcome home wall at our office so that when someone is found safe, we put their poster up and we ring a bell because we're saying welcome home. Like, we're really glad to have you back.
Talk about this documentary. It wasn't done in a matter of a few days, weeks, or months. This is in depth and it took a lot of work. Talk to me, give me a big picture. Tell me about this.
Sure. In the initial stages of the project, we looked at a 6-month window for getting to know the ins and outs of the Nick family and the areas that they haven't spoken much over the years, and how could we bring light to certain elements that would help to elevate this case and keep Morgan's name in the public, keep people talking about what happened 25 years ago. And it naturally developed into what ended up being two and a half years of filming, and then total from start to finish, almost a 4-year project.
You're from the area?
I'm from Van Buren.
You grew up here.
I grew up in Van Buren. I remember vividly my own parents telling me at ball fields, stay close, you know what happened in Alma. And that's something that's always been at the back of my mind and so many people from this area. And when the opportunity came up to actually dive into this story in a way that hadn't been done, I didn't want to pass that up, and it was something that I felt, being from this area, was a story that I really wanted to tell, and in hopes that we could actually make a difference in a case that had been lasting for 25 years. We hoped that we could bring a resource that would be unlike anything else that the case had at this point.
But you also got new key elements in an ongoing active investigation with nearly unprecedented access to investigators, even FBI agents who are actively working Morgan's case right now. Tell me about that.
Well, it was definitely exclusive. It's unusual to have that type of access or involvement from agents on an open case. But when collectively the teams of investigators and the Nick family looked at what the hope for this documentary was, it was a collective agreement that if this could bring some type of good and if it could bring a benefit that the case hasn't had, then it's worth that. And I commend the investigators for allowing that to happen. It's not something that's typical. It's very unusual. But they opened themselves up. They opened the investigation up for us to come in the hopes that we might actually be able to provide some resource that they didn't have. And I would like to say that we were able to provide them something like that, but also in the end, the goal of having this across the nation for millions of people to see, and in the words of Patty Wetterling in the documentary, kids are found because people don't forget. And so we wanted to make sure that cases like this, but also scenarios like this, still exist. And the more people can know about that, the more that people can see Morgan's story and Patty's story with her son Jacob, the more people can be aware to not only prevent it from happening, but to keep their eyes and ears open today for cases like this.
And when hearing sections with her talk, what stuck with me is when she mentioned veterans or something, referring to POWs and referring to missing children as almost like equating to missing in action.
That's right.
That really stuck with me. Yeah.
That's right. I mean, again, answers are something that you hope and pray for in cases like this, especially after they persist for so long. And until you have an answer, until you are able to find some type of a closure in a case like this for a family, they are essentially missing in action. I couldn't say it any better than Patty said it in the documentary.
The key piece of evidence. I was up late last night, mm-hmm. watching as the evidence came back, mm-hmm. one after the other, inconclusive, mm-hmm. can't tell. Mm-hmm. Then a microscopic piece of fiber. Mm-hmm. What's next? I have a feeling you're not done, are you?
No, no one involved in this case is done. All that does is it allows us to refocus what we're looking at and what investigators can say. We've spent years with resources out across a broad spectrum, and now they can refocus that, and they can say, after 25 years, this is where we're going and this is what we're asking for. We're looking for very specific evidence, they're going down a very specific path to try to get to the end of this. And I think, I think the message of the documentary is very clear. It's very concise that If you are someone who's victimized by this man, they're looking for you. The documentary in itself gives a very clear evidence of what you speaking out about your own victimization. It doesn't have to be publicly. It can be to investigators. It can be, directly to an FBI agent. And it's your name never has to be known. But what that can do for other children who have been victimized possibly by the same person, it's please come forward and talk about that. And what that's done is it's allowed investigators to say, give us this specific piece of information, help us this way, because the public has been such a help in Morgan's case for so many years now.
Billy Jack Links, did I say that correctly? Mm-hmm. And I remember the FBI put out, first time I've ever seen that, mm-hmm. put out and said, mm-hmm. asked the public for any information about Mr. Links, and not just here in Arkansas, from across the country. Texas, if memory serves, is
right.
that correct?
Right.
And I'm interested to see what they get back.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I think everybody is. I think knowing the past victimization in this person's history, there's no telling how many victims he had. And so it's important, as is seen so clearly in Jacob's case, when people who have been taken advantage of and been victimized against their own will, they still have a pretty strong voice to be able to come forward and seek justice in a way that they may not have thought that they could. And so that's what we're hoping with this.
Season one is available now. What about season two? Is that in the works? Do we know? Are you allowed to say?
I'm not allowed to say.